So wonderful, you people.
They're so lovely. Look at this crowd. They're so lovely.
Thank you.
Isn't that cute? What's next, Leslie?
We're going to hoot like some owls. Feel like
hooting? We're
going
to hoot like owls.
So it's that time.
Oh, man. Oh, I have an actual owl story. And this was long before being mugged by an owl became popular. Because apparently, you know, like running up to the guy and hitting him, you know, as a fad, began with the animals.
So,
okay, so I was I was living in Fairfax, California, up on a hill, way up on a hill. And I don't know if anybody here knows Fairfax, but it's kind of like it's woodsy.
In a house or just on the hill?
No, just on a hill. No, actually in a house. It was after a gig. It was really late. It was like, you know, I mean, the sun was practically coming up. I had just gotten back. I unloaded all my stuff. And I thought, I'm going to go for a walk. So I'm walking down the hill. It's dark. It's quiet. It's beautiful, you know, stars. It was a beautiful night. And I was enjoying my buzz in my walk. And suddenly, man, I was struck. I was struck down. Like, I had to take a knee. I was down on the ground, and I put my hand on my head, and I had blood. And I was like, what, I get shot or what? You know, it's a real, you know, WTF moment, man. And so I'm looking around, like, for my assailant, you know, from what direction comes danger next, right? And then I see, like, right next to me right here, there's a pickup truck with a ladder rack. And on the ladder rack is this little owl. It wasn't even a big owl. He was, like, the size of this coffee cup. And he's looking at me like this. He's got the look, you know, he's got the little beak and the eyes, man, and he's taking me down. And I look up, and then right above me, there was a wire, and it had been sitting on the wire. And I worried momentarily that I had been somehow poisoned by the owl, man, because, he, you know, how scalps, you know, scalp wounds, they bleed. So I called my doctor. I said, Doctor, Mr. MD, can you tell me? I told him the story about being attacked by the owl. I had concluded that as I passed under the wire, the predator had mistaken the top of my head for a sick or injured animal. And this is a true story. And the doctor tells me, Steve, get a haircut. Okay. All right.
Yes. Never.
That's a good doctor, man. So in this next song, you are all supposed to hoot as if you'd mistaken the top of my head for a sick or injured animal.
Let's do this. Hoot, hoot. Hoot, hoot. Hoot, hoot. Hoot, hoot. Bunch of owls. Bunch of owls on a Friday night. Hoo, hoo. You guys keep doing that while I sing?
Do you want to go down, go downtown? Do you want to go down? Do you want to go down? Do you as we get so high, as we get so high, floating like we're 10 feet off the ground, above the crowd. Won't you listen to the sound? Won't you listen to the sound? Satellite city. won't you come out tonight? Won't you come out tonight? Won't you come out
good hooting. Thank you. Yeah, we can go right into that.
Lord, I miss you.
Story on that same hill about a skunk. That was really good too. I don't do that now.
Some night, some hill. Oh, okay. How long were you on this hill for?
You're trying to squeeze me into telling that skunk story, aren't you?
I feel like it wouldn't take much.
It's not gonna happen.
Come on.
Now there'll be no skunk stories tonight. I mean ordinarily for a smooth talker like you, yes, but no.
You only get one animal story a night, apparently.
Thank you.
And now for something completely different. No, it's not going to be completely different. It's not going to be like a plate of shrimp or something. It could be, but it's not. Anybody here remember Repo Man? You know what I'm talking about? Plate of shrimp? Okay, thank you.
Guitar looks like Pac-Man.
What?
It's like Pac-Man.
This?
Yeah, guitar, yeah. Oh, what year is that?
You know.
No, it's amazing. It's an amazing guitar. I've never asked it.
I don't have my glasses.
Oh, never mind.
Thank God.
Oh, never mind. Well, that does it.
You're not really in a key when you play this stuff. If you play the guitar, you're supposed to have a boogie. You're supposed to have a boogie. This is a boogie. This is the fingernail boogie. Thank you. that thing with your feet again. Leslie's called an audible.
Just because this is the guitar, you know. Thanks. The stripes kind of matches.
Thank you.
working and waiting in the hot sun. With all the rich saints and the fallen ones, working and waiting for the night to come. And the waiting for, and the waiting for, and the waiting for a miracle. Somewhere out there is a land that's cool. But peace and balance are the rules. Working for the future like some kind of mystic jewel. And the waiting for, and the waiting for, and the waiting for a miracle. Brother Paul, the crime and pain and the hopes that you can see. Tall, put your back up strong in the hopes that you can be. Like the ones that cry, like the ones that shine, trying to set the angels in a spring. When you're waiting for her, when you're waiting for her, when you're waiting for her. Thank you. future has to take such a long, long time. When you're waiting for a, when you're waiting for a, when you're waiting for a miracle. When you're waiting for a, when you're waiting for a, when you're waiting for a miracle. When you're waiting for a,
for Jerry. Jason Reed, ladies and gentlemen. Jason Reed. I know. He's doing all sorts of stuff going on, making us sound pretty.
We're not always entirely clear exactly what it is, but it's always very beautiful.
My contacts, they're so dry.
Oh, what an excuse. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, that's about all we got time for tonight. Thank you so much for coming to the show. We appreciate the support. It's nice to be here. Leslie Mendelson on the piano and the vocal and the guitar. Bobby Vega on the bass. John Kimock on the drums.